Hello, everybody, and welcome to Psychic Medium Toni Green. I'm Toni Green, the Psychic Medium. All right, so I just want to quickly thank WSCS, Rude Ranger, Roku, Apple TV, all the stations that we are streamed on. And a quick reminder that, yes, this does air on actual TV, as well as radio stations and podcasts. So when you call in, just be a little bit mindful of that. If you would like to call in and ask a question or connect with a loved one on the other side, the call-in number is 845-277-9131. And if you would like to watch us or join us while we're doing the live show, it's every Monday and Wednesday. You can join live by calling that number or just joining us on YouTube. So I want to thank everybody on YouTube who's already joined us. Heather, Fawn, Sal, Patrick. Thank you so much, Terry. Hey, everybody. And Susie, hey, good morning to you too. I want to answer a couple questions that I've already received on YouTube, and then I'm going to head over to the call log. And if you do call in, it's one question per caller, and it is or one connection. Okay, let me go to the first question came from Heather, and it was, should she pursue the insurance job part-time? And what I'm getting on that is a yes, no. I feel like if you pursue it, you'll probably get it, but you won't love it. I think you're doing it because you feel like you have to, not because you want to. So it'll become more of a burden than anything to you. Okay. Now, Fawn is asking, did the surgery cause my mother's issues? The best way I can say this is like this. There was an... Did the surgery cause the issue? Yes. Now, there was something going on with your mother prior to the surgery that also, if that had not have been going on, the surgery would not have caused this issue. There was like an underlying issue and the surgery antagonized it or brought it up. I hope I'm saying that correctly. So yes, I hope that's that answer helps you. Okay. Can I ask, when will I meet my man? Oh, Terry, when will you meet your man? November. They're getting so specific with you guys. I'm getting November, and then I see 14th, 15th on the calendar, and then I also see the 18th. So make sure you're out and about on those days, and you're looking around, not in your phone. Hey, Ozzy! Oh my gosh, Ozzy, how are you? I'm so happy you joined us here today. Okay, those are the questions on YouTube. Now, what did I just do to my bangs? The hair challenge with women is real, guys. It's so real. You guys don't know how lucky you have it. You don't. You just don't know how lucky you have it. You know, you don't have to use all the special products. I mean, you can if you want, but you don't have to. The hair struggle is real with women. I'm just saying, thank you so much, Patrick. So Heather colored her roots. That's always the best feeling in the world is when we just get our hair done. It's never better than that first week of getting our hair done. Yes. Thank you so much, Terry. Okay, I'm gonna start taking callers and I'm going to say your area code. When I say your area code, please tell me your first name and where you're calling from, and then have a somewhat specific question or connection available. Okay. Hey, Susie. Susie needs help. I feel like I lost so much. Do you see anything I need to do or can do that I am not? That's kind of vague, Susie. I'm going to ask you to call in, Susie. The call in, if you can call in, the call in number is 845-277-9131. Yeah, you have had some very, very significant loss. Is there anything I need to do or I can do that I'm not doing? Okay, so whatever your faith or belief is, don't take this the wrong way, but the first thing I'm hearing is pray. And when I think of prayer for me might be a little bit different than for other people. I don't go to a book and pull something out. I just talk directly to angels and God, and I let them know what's going on. And I sometimes will tell them, this is what I need. Because as most of us already know, angels don't intervene unless we ask them to. They don't step in and do things unless it's an emergency situation. Then they will step in and do something. But if it's not an emergency situation and we're wanting or needing something, it's always best to go into that state of meditation or prayer or whatever you call it, communication with the divine or the other side, and ask them or let them know how you would like them to intervene and what you would like. I'm also getting you can call on certain ancestors to help you with that, and they'll be very, very happy to bring in your strength. And on that note, let's do our first clearing of the show. And the first clearing is we, hopefully it hits me here. This one's hitting me right in the stomach and the solar plexus. It's really hitting me there. So let's clear that. All that cause this has cleared. I get a no. Let's clear that. You guys, I need you to know I clear all of these things for myself on a steady. So when I get on here and I'm having like this, it's definitely yeah, it's a collective clearing. Oh. And then there it is. Let me know if you guys feel that. I'm going to go straight to caller 203. 203, what's your name and where are you calling from?
Hi, Toni. It's Pat from Connecticut.
Hey, Pat, how can I help you today?
Last time I spoke with you mentioned that my son was going to affect me in either 6 days or I think 6 weeks. I visited with him. It was successful. It's slow progress with him. Can you tell me how that went, or is that what affected me? I got really pretty depressed, but money's really affecting me too.
Yeah, you know what, Pat? I'm going to say this. I'm going to say a couple of things here. When we reconnect with someone we haven't connected with in a bit, we always want to have that faith and hope, and we don't jump in blindly, but we want to have the hope that everything's going to work out and be okay. And then we kind of tiptoe and we're on eggshells, and don't do that. Because what's going on in your mind right now is a back and forth between what happened in the past and what could happen in the future, along with Am I doing the right thing? There's a lot of fear in this situation. And we don't look at it as fear. We look at it as, you know, just moving forward. The first thing I'm going to do for you, everybody listening, everybody re-listening, watching, re-watching, we're going to clear the fear. So you may feel this and it may feel very strong. Now, the one thing that I will say is when we go through emotions, we go through them on a, let's clear that. And we're going to see what comes of this. So please let me know for you, anybody online, anybody listening, watching, let me know what you're feeling with this. I do want to say, I want to say this to you. Move forward slowly and carefully. Sometimes people change, but sometimes the change is temporary. So just move forward slowly and carefully. Don't have expectations and don't, you know, if you, I'm not going to say that. Yeah, just move
forward. What?
If you move, just move forward, just move forward slowly and be, don't have expectations. That's the best thing I can say for you. And I hope that that is helpful for you. I know that that did affect you. That's part of what's affecting you. There's a number of other things that are affecting you. And what I would say for you is spend a lot of time in meditation or prayer, spend a lot of time like releasing it, if you will. Okay, love?
Okay. Can you tell me is he making slow progress bit by bit? I'm patient. I don't have big expectations.
No. The solid answer I'm receiving is no. And again, I'm gonna say this to you. You know, when it comes to family situations, that it's kind of a facade. There's something.
Yeah, I know that.
There's something he wants. And I don't like to put it this way, but if I'm being blatant and blunt, he's basically working you right now. He's really working you because there's a specific outcome he wants. And so go very slow, tread lightly, and don't have high expectations. And the part of what's going on with you is you see that, you know, when we love someone, especially men and women, when we love somebody, our ability to be in denial is at an all-time high. I'm sorry, I'm giggling at that because I'm not laughing at your situation. I'm just thinking of my own past situations where, you know, and then our head and our gut and our heart are fighting each other. Like, okay, I kind of think this is the truth. I know this is the truth. Intuitively, I'm getting this is the truth. But if I look at this truth, then I have to take this action. And I'm not ready to take that action yet. And I think that's where some of your emotional stuff is affecting you, because you know the truth. Yeah. You're just not wanting to jump on it.
I do know the truth. I'm putting myself under the assumption that letting him talk to me about, you know, complaining, being hopeless and so on, helps him.
Okay.
And I could be wrong.
Okay. Here's what I'm going to say about that. Sometimes that does help if the person is looking for a solution or an answer or help. But if they're just complaining to complain, and I cannot stress this enough, they're reaffirming the negative program in their brain. Now, when we say something, whether it be to another person or ourselves, we say it once, a little dot in our brain is connected. We say it again, another that is connected. We create a synapsis, which becomes a program, which becomes a belief, which becomes a way of life. So if he's looking for an answer or a solution, and he wants wants help and therapy and or to get this resolved, go for healing or whatever it is. That's one thing. But if he's saying it just to complain and he's, and I know everybody needs somebody to talk to, but if there's no action following that of, listen, I hear what you're saying. I'm validating what you're saying. These are the steps you need to take. If they don't want to hear about the steps, if they don't want to hear about the solution, they're just, you know what? They're just reinforcing the program and they're stuck. Okay. And until they're ready to get unstuck, you can listen. You're a mom. You should listen, but you should also try to have resources, steps, or things that can be done along with that. I hope that makes sense, love.
I hear you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And
it helps.
You know, if he can't...
A lot of clarity. Thank you.
Thank you. And if he can't go to a therapist, ask him different... Don't just listen. Ask him different questions that will make him look at it differently. Make him run a new program in his mind. And those difference, if he's complaining about, let's just say a relationship, say, this is my favorite, one of my favorite questions when people talk to me about relationship stuff and they're stuck in a really difficult situation. I'll say to them, how much longer do you think you can, you know, do this? Do you think you can do this for another week? Everybody inevitably says, oh, yeah, I got this for a week. Do you think you can do this for another year? That they're like, no, I can't do this for another year. Okay, if you can't do this for another year, how much longer can you do it for 5 months? Because people live day to day repeating in this cyclical day to day life. And when you put it to them that way, they start like timing it. And then you can say, well, have you thought about a get out plan? Have you thought about a way to dissolve it? Have you thought about this? What do you think your best action would be? Ask open-ended questions. Even if he can't answer them in the moment, he may be able to answer them later on to himself. It's not the answer that's important. Right. Sometimes it's the question and reopening a different part of the brain. Okay.
Yep. I get it. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. You have an amazing rest of the day.
Love you, Toni.
Love you too, sweetie. And good luck. Good luck. Okay.
Thank you.
You are welcome. I'm going to go directly to 313-313. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hi, my name is Brian, and I'm calling from Indiana.
Hey, Brian.
And good to talk to you again. Good to talk to you again. I was calling because I am planning to move back home to Michigan soon, and I'm trying to see how things are going to go with my step siblings. My father, and I really didn't get along that well, but we made our peace after he had a stroke back in February. But my step siblings have been slow to kind of warm up to me throughout my life. And I just want to know, how do you see things going for me when I move back to Michigan with them?
Okay. So when you move back to Michigan, and I always, I love this statement. You know, we were given our family to kind of train for the world, and we were given our friends to feel like family. Don't have high expectations. I feel like your step siblings are very, I hate to say this. They see you kind of as, and I don't use this word lightly. They see you as a threat in some way, for some reason, and not like a physical threat, but maybe just the way everything goes or whatever it is. I feel like eventually they will come around a bit more, but they will always be guarded. Okay. I think that they will always be guarded. Okay. And when you go back, don't have the idea or the feeling that they are going to just all of a sudden be in a space where they are able to accept things. It's going to be a long road for that. Okay, love?
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like...
absolutely.
Yeah, I honestly feel like... And here's the other thing I want to say on this note. You don't owe anybody anything, not even to prove who you are, and especially not to prove your worth or that you belong in any situation. You owe no one nothing. You don't have to show up and prove you're valid or prove that you deserve to be like in their grace, which is not very graceful, I might add. You show up as you and show up kind of with a opinion or an attitude of, you know, I can take it or leave it. I'm going to be kind. I'm going to be loving. I'm going to be me, but I'm not going to work at some, I'm not going to work at making this work. Either it works or it doesn't. Either you're good or you're not. Either we're good or we're not. But don't try to prove, it's not proving. Don't try to, I guess the simple way to say it is, don't try to get them to accept you or get them to, don't try to show them who you are. They already know you're solid and you're good. Okay. They already know that. This is a them issue, as you know, and there's nothing you can do to fix that issue. And that's on them. That's on them. You're not going back for them. So go back with the idea that you are going to be, you know, doing what you need to do there. Okay.
If I may ask, how do you see things going for me in Michigan overall, despite them?
Good. I see them going good. Now, they will get better. They'll get better as time goes on. I'm going to be honest with you, Brian. I don't see you staying in Michigan very long. I see you being there for a little bit of time, but not very long. I feel like you're going to be there at around the 3 or 4 month mark. You're going to realize maybe that you're going to realize whatever you're there might not be whatever. And at the 6 month mark, you're going to start looking for your next location. And I feel like, and again, this is all choice. This is, I'm not directing your life. You could go there and say, nope, I'm going to make it work no matter what. But around the 3 or 4 month mark, you're going to realize this might not be the place for you. Around the 6 month mark, you're really going to start looking for your next location, if I can put it that way. And then after that, once everything, and I don't know what they mean by once everything is settled and done, you're going to then really solidify your next location, okay?
Okay.
When everything unfolds and the way it unfolds, you're going to understand better. Now, when you go with the idea and the understanding that you're going to do everything you can to make your life there work and be as happy as it can. But then also, you know, be open to the fact that it's a big, beautiful world. And if you end up landing someplace else, that's okay too. Okay.
Okay.
Excellent. I hope.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. And I really hope this was helpful.
Anyways, talk to you soon.
Okay. Thank you. I'm going to go to 904. 904, what's your name and where are you calling from?
Hi, this is Wendy calling from Florida.
Hey, Wendy, how can I help you today?
Hi. Hi. I started a job last week, and I'm not qualified for, and not qualified, not trained for, and I wanted to find another spot in the company. Do you see that happening, or I'm going to end up somewhere else?
That's up to you, and it depends on how much patience that you have. I do feel like the company is going to move you from within to another location. I don't know that that location is going to be any better than the one you are in right now. They're filling their need regardless of what any employee wants or is qualified right now. They're kind of going on the fly. So wherever they have the need and when they have that need is where they will move you, if I'm tapping into the company. Right now I'm just tapping into the company. So they're filling needs. They're not concerned with the fact that you're not very qualified for this position. They're more concerned with just filling the position and thinking you can be like kind of trained on the spot for it. Now, in about a month or so, within or around a month's time, they will move you. I can't say that where or how they're going to move you is any better, if you'll like it any more than where you're at right now. If you have the patience, if you have patience, in about 6 months, you'll be happier with the company. You'll be in a better position and you'll be happier with the company. It's about 6 months. I do think also that if you decide that you want to move on or go to another position, please keep this. I know you know to keep this position while you're looking, no matter how frustrated you are. I do feel like if you do decide to look for another position, you will find one. It will be a little better. It will be, you'll feel more qualified for it and more in place for it, if that makes sense. And that'll be in about a month. Through the process of finding it, interviewing and everything, that'll be between the 4 and 6 week mark that position comes in. Okay, love?
Okay.
Excellent.
All right. Thank you.
I hope this was helpful.
Yes, thank you.
You are welcome, and thank you so much for calling in. I do hope this was helpful for everybody listening. Please know that you are loved. I will be back Monday at noon for another 30 or 60 minute show. Until then, you guys have an amazing rest of the week. And thank you again so much for joining me. Thank you.